Hi, it's Shannon here from houseimprovements.com. And I showed you a video a while ago installing this luxury vinyl plank on these stairs. And I've heard a lot of comments that it's really slippery and dangerous. I'm here to debunk that. So that was one of the many comments that we had on that video. And I just wanted to kind of do a follow-up video, just kind of going through some of the most common comments we've had, pro vinyl plank and the cons sort of thing. People had different questions about it, so I just thought it was worth a video. Like I said, number one thing was lots of people commented that, oh, those would be so slippery and, you know, they're dangerous, somebody's gonna fall down them, whatever. Well, in all honesty, and I have replied this to many of those comments, the luxury vinyl plank that this customer used actually has a pretty good texture to it. And I honestly wouldn't use a really smooth vinyl plank flooring on stairs. They are right, they could get pretty slippery. Probably no slipperier though than a hardwood stair, but they would be slippery. This one has some texture, so it's really not slippery at all. Like even in my stocking feet, it takes quite a bit to slide my foot even. So I don't think that's not an issue. This has been, I don't know, we must be getting close to 2 years now since these stairs have been finished, and not one of these people have fallen down the stairs. They did mention that it's a little more slippery for their pets, but the pets just got to go slower. These stairs have not hurt any humans. So anyways, slippery? No, I say no. Another common question is this nosing. A few questions about the nosing. I've had the odd person comment, well, that's a tripping hazard because the nosing actually laps over the vinyl plank. So you get this little transition right here. This nosing is designed, that's how it's designed, is to go over. It's not designed to butt in. I'm not sure. Maybe you could make it butt in, but that isn't what it was intended to do. It is intended to overlap like that and glue onto the stairs, or onto the flooring, I mean. So this, it's hard to show you exactly how thick this is, but this is, I never measured it. I would say it's about an eighth of an inch, if it's even that much. And it is got a bit of a slight taper there. I'm not sure if you can really tell that on the camera, if that helps or not. So anyways, is the nosing a tripping hazard? No, I've seen much worse. There's other metal nosings where you've got like almost a quarter inch lip, and I would say they're more of a tripping hazard than this stuff is. Another thing about the nosing is there another way of creating a nosing? And I've actually seen some people will take the pieces of plank and make up a jig where they heat the plank and they actually will fold the actual plank around to make it rounded like that. And they'll use the flooring itself as the nosing. So that wouldn't have a transition in it. It would just be continuous, so that may be better. I've never done it myself. One of these days I'm gonna have to give it a try and see how it works. But I've definitely seen people make the nosing with the actual flooring. So it's kind of seamless. Now, the other thing, if you watched our original video, everything here is glued down. So the flooring, the tread part and the riser part, they're glued to the wood. This nosing is glued to the flooring and as well to the wood nose. And so we've had people question, because traditionally, a lot of vinyl planks aren't designed, and this actually had a cushioned back, so it wasn't designed to be glued down. So they're wondering, you know, because we didn't leave any room on the edges for expansion and contraction, did this cause any issues? You know, did these pieces want to try to expand or contract and cause buckling or anything? And again, no, there's nothing loose. Everything stayed glued. Like I said, we're almost probably 2 years since we did this install. Nothing seems to be loose. And honestly, on a short length like this, you really shouldn't get much expansion and contraction anyways. You know, in a room that's 15 feet long where you've got five of these planks put together, that's where you're going to notice some actual expanding, and the manufacturer wants you to leave a quarter inch gap or whatever around anything that's fixed. So again, because we glued them down, no, there doesn't seem to be any issue with expansion and contraction, loosening the stairs off. What else was there? I'm just looking at my list here. Oh, back to the nosing. We had one person actually ask if you had an open stair, like let's say this side, there was no wall and there was no stringer on the side, and this stair just went out and was open. Could you still use this? And I don't see why not. I've never done it. But you should be able to miter the corner and miter another piece and put it along that edge there. So I don't see there's any reason you couldn't use this on an open set of stairs. I really can't see any kind of issue with it. So on this flooring, as I showed you a few minutes ago, there's a backing. There's kind of a foam, really thin foam backing on here. In the video where we installed it, we peeled all that backing off because I just wasn't sure if the glue would adhere to this foam backing or whether that backing would release from the glue. So we pulled it off so we could glue right to the backside of the vinyl plank. I've had a few people comment that they actually have in fact just glued right to the foam. Now there's a few different types of foam, so I don't know exactly which foam backing they had. So I don't want to say that it'll work, but some people have just left the backing on and still glued it down. I didn't. I removed the backing, and it was a pain in the butt, but I knew for sure that the glue was going to stick then. Then another couple people commented, because if you go back and watch that video, when we finished up, there was the stringer here, and then there was a bit of an unsightly gap between the stringer and the drywall. And when I was doing the stairs, it was more about the flooring, putting the flooring on, and the homeowner was gonna finish up the side piece here. So they've obviously done that since I was here last, and they've put on this piece of batten or whatever it is, piece of MDF probably, painted it up to match the stringers. And then they put just a small little bead of caulk from the drywall to here, which just totally finishes it off and gives it a better finished look. So that, again, that's exactly what I would advise, whether it's flat or a cove or whatever kind of molding or treatment you want to do there, just hides the unsightly gap that there would have been there originally, because the stairs are never built right tight to the drywall. Generally, there is a gap there you've got to hide. And these stairs were carpeted originally, so they just bring the carpet up here and run it right to the drywall, so you don't see that gap in that case. But in this case, we need to finish that off so that the gap didn't show up, and this is what they did, and it looks great. So I think that kind of covers some of the main comments we've had on the video. I kind of like this idea of coming back to jobs we've done in the past and just having a look at them and answering a few questions and seeing how everything's holding up a little while later. So hope you enjoyed it too. You can always check out all our other different social media, whether it be on Patreon, Facebook, Twitter, all those. You can check that all out, and we'll put links in the video description for you if you want to have a look at them. Thanks for watching.